breakfast is the most important meal of the day, but according to teenagers, it's also the most challenging. You know, they always booked and stuff. All right, so the New York Times food column reported that 40% of millennials said that cereal is, guess what, y'all? Calm down. An inconvenient food.
What?
Yes, it's inconvenient food because it requires cleanup after eating it. Yes. The retail study says that millennials didn't care if the cereal was hot or if it was cold. They just simply don't want it because they don't want to do no dishes.
Whoa.
Now, Adrian, do you think they got a point? You the youngest at the table? Or do you think eating cereal, does that try your entire life just like these millennials out here, or they just flat out lazy?
I thought that cereal was like the easiest food to eat.
No.
It doesn't take much.
No.
First of all, I love cereal. I actually think it's a very childish food. You know, I'm here for all those flavorful, you know, Fruity Pebbles, Lucky Charms, Twit Berries. My favorite of all time is Cheerios. But the simple fact is, don't they know about plastic bowls?
I don't think they do. I think they still use like the big bowls.
They have paper bowls and plastic spoons.
When it comes to millennials, I think they just like things to be expedient. You know what I mean? Like
instant gratification.
Yes. Like if a video on Instagram takes like 4 seconds too long, they're like on to the next.
Okay.
Like,
how much quicker can it get than cereal?
And milk.
You pour.
But then you gotta go to the refrigerator and get the milk.
Oh, that's real nice.
Hey, I think. What do they eat?
Can
cereal
I
bar?
Pop tart cereal
that takes
bars.
That takes long.
They don't actually heat it up like we did, though.
No, yeah.
I can't believe that they're so lazy that they can't go to the kitchen. But if you put an Xbox in the kitchen, they'll be there in 4 seconds.
Hey,
okay, I have to tell you guys something.
What?
So when I first heard about this topic that we're talking about, I was like, ugh, millennials, right? Like, I was so sure that I was not a millennial.
Are you a millennial?
Sure. You guys, I'm one of them.
No.
Yes. I don't know if... No, trust me, I thought I was not.
What's the official definition?
So a lot of people don't know what a millennial is, like where the cutoff is, where it starts and ends. What's the cutoff? Where does it start and end?
1981.
If you're born after 1981.
Oh, I barely made it.
1981. I was born in 83. I'm a millennial. Oh my god.
I think a millennial is a mindset, though. Like, it's a mindset in the way that they live, their style. Like what you just said, you are a little bit more mature in the way that you're thinking than a millennial. Not to say the millennials are immature, like what they
are.
Oh my god. Okay, what I'm saying,
stereotypically, millennials are like the ones that, you know, take a lot of selfies. I fit into that category.
Okay.
We are kind of addicted to our phones. I fall into that category. But I actually don't believe that I am lazy at all.
You're not.
But
you also don't cook, friend.
But that's because I actually like to go out to dining experiences, too.
Uh-oh.
Which takes more effort to, like, get up, get out.
Maybe Adrian is a millennial.
She is a millennial.
Yes, yes.
I mean, I'm sorry. Okay. I got a friend just the same. No shame. It's okay. Be who you are. Be proud of who you are.
Yeah. But I am a millennial.
Admit, though,
I
have you guys ever, okay, this might be just me, and that's fine. I'm okay on the island of Genie. When you're staying at home and you don't want to keep washing dishes, let's say you have a work day at home. Sometimes I have an office day. I don't want to keep washing my breakfast bowl and then my snack bowl and then that cup I had for lunch and then the bowl that I make with the pot that I cook. So I'll eat my breakfast in a bowl. And then I'll put the bowl in the fridge so that when lunch comes, I just put the lunch in a bowl. You can straighten your head out now. It's okay. I'm human. Then I put the lunch in the bowl that I use for breakfast so I don't have to wash two bowls.
Oh,
you don't have a dishwasher?
Yeah, that's real lazy, though.
Or you don't wash a dishwasher for what? A dishwasher is even more annoying for a person who's just me and Freddie because then you have to wait till it fills up.
Wait, why not just wash it and then put it to the side?
Because I don't want my nails to wash out.
Yeah, but Genie, it's
just like that.
Tasting the same. Now, I have this little cup in the summertime that you keep cold in the refrigerator, and I understand.
See?
Wait, hold your thought. Because, you know, I'm a real Southern girl, and when because it's hot in the summertime, you got your little cup, right?
Yep.
That you drink out of every time, and when you finish drinking out that cup, you just rinse around, put it back in the refrigerator, so when you're ready to get something else to drink, it's cold.
Oh, that's very smart.
Never thought of that.
But I don't know
all out no bowl. You just pouring stuff in.
Same thing.
Like, but don't your breakfast taste like your lunch?
No, it's cleaned out. I rinse it too.
Oh, so you rinse it out.
There might be a chia seed on the corner of it, but it goes right back in and comes back out.
But why is it going in the fridge? Is all your food cold?
No, because you wanna make sure it stays clean, and in the fridge there's no germs. It's just your fridge is the cleanest place where no like
No germs in the refrigerator.
If you leave a bowl that's not fully washed out, I think flies could get to it. Freddie comes to it, he cleans it for me, and I don't want him to touch it, so I put it in the top of the shelf.
You have a cupboard though, Jeannie.
No, the fridge, I believe in my mind. In my mind,
it works.
That Jeannie's things mind. In the fridge, if they're cold, they stay germ-free.
No.
Really? No. It's when you put hot water to it that the germs go away.
Science according to Jeannie Mai, ladies and gentlemen.
Hot water. That's not right.
Hot water to killing germs.
Pretty much.
Well, some parents have found a solution for lazy kids who don't do their chores. They bribe them. Are you that parent?
No.
So nowadays, parents are more inclined to give their kids money for simple tasks like brushing their teeth or cleaning their room. Critics of this parenting style say that chores should be about learning responsibility and not earning money. So we took this,
so you agree, we're in the house.
We took this topic to Facebook, and here's what some of our amazing fans had to say. Honey Wampler said, no way should they be paid for helping out. They live there too, and they need to contribute to the household. Okay? Sandy Hall said, making your bed, cleaning your room, setting the table, no. Making some extra cash by washing the car, pulling weeds, and cleaning the garage, yes. So she thinks that harder tasks should be paid for.
Nah.
Tam, you're a mom of two kids.
Yes.
Where do you stand? Are you going to start paying Aiden to do the chores around the house?
No.
Right.
Maybe when he gets a little bit older and he understands the value of working hard and the value of money. But right now, I think the blessing of having kids is saying, you know what, Aiden, can you go help me get that pamper? Please?
Yeah.
Go get the pamper for mommy. And he says, yes, mommy. Okay. I love that I have children to help me out. We were that for my parents.
Yeah,
we had
kids had to run go get the remote control.
And we had GI Fridays, which I'm an ex-Army brat. GI Fridays means General Inspection Friday. So every Friday after school, we had to GI our entire house. That's why General Inspection. That means you had to like get that toothbrush and you had to clean around. We had to clean. But I'm a clean person because of it. When I was younger, I didn't like it. But now, thank you, Mom and Dad, for teaching me how to be a clean lady. You see my house, Lonnie. It's immaculate.
Dressing room is spotless.
Just cleansing
it. You get that toothbrush still?
No, I don't get the toothbrush, but I am on my hands and knees, like cleaning. You're a germaphobe too, right? Right? No?
Yeah, but don't.
No? No? No, you are.
What do you mean?
Yeah, we are. I just can't do it. I'm not a good cleaner. Like, I can cook.
Got it.
Cleaning is not, you know, my strongest suit.
Okay, cleaning is therapeutic.
But I like to clean.
I like to clean.
But I ain't paying Logan to go do nothing, though. I'm going to tell him when I'm going to pay him, though. I'm going to pay him a spanking if you don't do what I ask you to do.
I'm not a parent, so I'm gonna ask. Mm-hmm. Why do some parents negotiate with their
children? I don't know, because they crazy. Ain't no way I'm not finna negotiate with you.
Like,
and I'm telling you what I want you to do. Yeah, I have that luxury. And that's why you millennials ask questions like that, because, you were raised up that old school child. What? It wasn't even a question to ask your parents. A question like, what you talking about?
Do you remember what would happen if you actually like made a noise or mouth back
at mom? Yeah, you were like, off the sheetrock. Exactly.
If she even heard me go, psh, what? Yeah. What you say? Psh, what? Oh, it's scary.
You couldn't even, suck your teeth. You know how you're like, please, mom, or roll your eyes? Forget about it.
Remember when dude was in? Have you ever called, if you go, dude?
Oh, yeah.
You said that to your mama?
Oh, my God, I almost lost my teeth.
Yes, you did.
It was crazy. She was like, who knew? Who knew?
You know what I did? I said, Mom, you crazy girl. She said, what? First of all, don't you ever call me crazy, and don't call me girl. I am your mama.
That's scary. Do you think kids should be paid for chores?
Well, when I grew up, My mama didn't even think about payment. My payment was watching Soul Train on the weekend. Right. So.
I think it teaches children to be a part of a family. Like, we're a team.
Yes.
It's a team effort. You've got to help out. You've got to join in. And hopefully it teaches them that you shouldn't have to get paid to be helpful.
Exactly.
Be helpful out of the kindness of your heart. And you see what your parents do for you, you should want to help out.
I don't think it's about paying for the chores, but I do think that children should be given some type of an allowance. And I say that because it teaches them about money. It teaches them about saving. It gives them some type of responsibility. So I remember I was in Target like 2 weeks ago, and I saw this little boy who's about maybe 6 or 7 years old, and I was in back of him, and he had a little toy, and his dad had paid for all his stuff, and the little boy had his little toy, and so he waited, and he's like, I was like, oh, that's so cute. He's gonna pay for his toy. He's like, yeah, he saved up his money. So that's when he got there, the toy was $7, but the little boy only had $5.
Aww.
And he said he's been saving for like 3 months and stuff like that. And you know,
damn.
And so the dad was about to give the $2. But I said, you know what, sir? No, this is a teachable moment. I said, I'm going to give you that $2 because you worked for 3 months. And so when you work, you deserve an award. And so,
Yeah, I think that's smart.
I remember the next time Logan wants something, you ask your Auntie Lonnie, she'll buy it.
I don't have a problem with that, Logan.
Ask for it. Well, doing